Dr. Mindy here, and on this video, I'm actually going to do a summary of this whole week. This has been Fast Training Week, and we've been talking about your fat-burning hormone. It's a totally different hormone than insulin. It is called leptin, and many of you are in leptin resistance. And so I wanted to take you step by step. How do you pull yourself out of leptin resistance? I've dove into the science on leptin resistance and fasting. We talked about it with foods, we talked about it with sleep, and we talked about it with metabolic stressors like exercise. So if you want more of the details, go back to the videos that I did the last few days diving into the specificity of each one of those things. And by the way, if you're new to my channel, I just want to say welcome. I am on a mission to teach you how powerful you are. I do that through what I call a fasting lifestyle. A fasting lifestyle is where you use the principles of food, you use the principles of fasting to tap into your own healing power. And when it comes to losing weight, it is so important that you understand that it's not because you're undisciplined, it's not because of your genetics, it's because you've not been taught the proper way to kick yourself out of insulin resistance and out of leptin resistance. So on this video, I'm going to summarize 12 different ways that you can go about getting yourself out of leptin resistance and finally burning fat for fuel. So welcome, and as always, share this video out into the world so we can all get healthy together. Okay. Ready? Rapid fire. I love checklists. So this video is a checklist video. So if you are stuck with weight, this is where you want to like actually write down everything that I'm about to say and then ask yourself if you're doing this. So the first part of getting yourself out of leptin resistance is you want to look at three different types of fasts. The research is showing us dry fasting can get you out of leptin resistance, that there's an autophagy dysfunction that happens with people who have leptin resistance, so you want to lean into more autophagy fasting, and then the 24-hour fast. So if you're not familiar with autophagy fasting, I got thousands of videos it feels like I've done on autophagy fasting, so there's a lot on here where you can go and search that. But the three fasts are dry fast, and remember, I don't recommend more than 24 hours dry fast. Dry fast, autophagy fasting, and the 24-hour fast. Those are your go-to leptin-resistant fasts. Okay, we also talked about there are four food changes you need to make to kick yourself out of leptin resistance. So first one, you're gonna keep your carbs down. This is definitely proven over and over to keep those carbs down, but you're gonna increase your protein. Those of you that are doing a low keto diet or you're doing ketobiotic or a keto vegetarian, you want to increase your protein, not a ton. You could increase it by 15%. 15-20% is what the science is saying. The second thing is many of you are lectin sensitive, not to be confused with leptin. This is lectin. Lectins are in your cereals, your millets, your grains. They're also in corn, rice, quinoa. They're also in your beans, your all types of legumes, and they're also in pasteurized dairy. So you might need to take those lectins out in order to get yourself leptin sensitive again. So food number two is decrease your lectins. The third thing you're going to want to do, and this is for those of you that are getting blood tests regularly, I want you to look at your triglycerides. The lower your triglycerides, when they're in a healthy, normal range, you're going to bring your leptin levels down. So make sure you're bringing your triglycerides down. The research I showed you in that video was from the New England Journal of Medicine showing that a low-carb diet is one of the strategies for bringing your triglycerides down. And then the fourth food, and this is just a good general principle, is avoid processed foods. Processed foods are fake foods. They have the inflammatory oils. They're usually high in sugar. They will make you both insulin sensitive and they'll make you leptin sensitive. So if you are looking to take your weight loss to the next level, look at those four food principles and you can match them to the fasts. And I'll show you again how this all plays out on a weekly basis in a moment. So stay tuned. Okay, the third thing we talked about was sleep. So there were three things you had to look at with sleep. We had to look at how much sleep you were getting. So remember I said you have to get at least more than 5 hours. 5 hours and less was making people more leptin resistant. But then we also looked at the power of making sure that you're getting morning sunlight, that that morning light will set your circadian clock and can help with bringing leptin levels down. We also talked about red light therapy. And then the third piece of sleep was consistency. When you go to bed at midnight one night, get up at 5, the next night you go to bed at 9, get up at 8, that up and down with your habits of sleep is really damaging to your brain and can affect how your brain will start to heal and process fat. So with sleep, you want to work on those three things. And then the last piece we talked about was metabolic stressors. So many of you guys, I mean, many of us, when we come to these principles, we get so excited about being a fat burner, but the name of the game isn't to be a fat burner. The name of the game is to go in and out of this metabolic switching state. And so there are a couple ways you can do that. You can pair any of those three fasts I just taught you. So I taught you how to dry fasting, autophagy, 24 hour. You compare that with a feasting meal. Now, in my book, there are three types of feasting meals. There's feasting for your hormones, where you're bringing, this is definitely not a keto plan. I wrote about it in the menopause reset. It's coming out, by the way, in print in April. So if you want to pre-order that, we'll just put menopause reset and we'll leave you a link. But what I notice is that so many women, especially, we go into this restriction with keto and it throws our hormones off. So if we want to use the principles of metabolic stressors and switching, you could do like a 24 or a 17 hour fast and combine it with some hormone building foods. Now you're using that, you're stressing and you're recovering, you're stressing and you're recovering, and that in and out is what is bringing leptin, both insulin and leptin, down. So that would be one strategy. The other thing we talked about this week was HIIT training. That when you do an exercise that brings your heart rate up and then you recover, and that brings your heart rate up and then you recover, that metabolic stressing mechanism will also bring leptin down. So what this could look like for you in a week schedule is some days you do intermittent fasting, 13 to 15 hours, and you follow that with a keto meal. The next day, you could do a longer fast. You could do a 24-hour fast and maybe do carnivore that night. The next day, you could decide, hey, I'm going to autophagy fast this day. And you can do 17 hours and keep your protein down and break your fast with fat. It's all of the switching in and out of the different fasts and the different foods that is going to bring both of these hormones down. And those of you who have been through any of my resets before, you know this is what I'm teaching. If that's really confusing to you, I always tell people start with a 5-1-1. 5 days a week, intermittent fast, and choose an eating style of your choice. 1 day a week, fast 24 hours. 1 day a week, don't fast. That's a really good metabolic switching routine. The other thing is look at your exercise variation. A lot of times we just do the same exercise over and over and over again. But what we learned this week with leptin resistance is that we need to push the body and then relax the body. So some days you could do a hard workout. The next day you could do yoga. Some days you could go on a hike. The next day you do sprints. So it's the variation that's going to really have an impact when you're looking at your exercise. And then the last thing I'll just remind you again is sleep matters. So many of you guys are working really hard at building a fasting lifestyle and then you don't get a result, and sleep might be that piece. So make sure you go back and watch the sleep video that I did. But that was leptin. Like, I'm pretty excited about this playlist we created this week, because I feel like you guys that are trying to lose weight, go back, and there's 5 videos here. There's actually 6 if you count the one I did last week. We have 6 videos under one whole playlist. And if you watch those videos in order, you will see that there is a system here to start to get your leptin and your insulin to be more sensitive. And honestly, what we see over and over and over again is people drop weight like this. And they do because they're working in alignment with the principles of how your body was designed. If I have completely confused you, we have a companion guide to all this week. Just put companion guide in the notes and in the comments, we'll make sure you get it. And those of you that are menopausal, the menopause reset, I'm so excited to show you what I did in my 40s to balance my hormones. So it is coming out. Just put menopause reset and we'll send you a link on how you can pre-order it. But don't ever give up on yourself, please. You're like a Lamborghini that nobody gave you the manual, so you don't know how, you haven't been taught how to use it. And that's what we're trying to do here on this channel. You're amazing and have an incredible day.